Today, I want to show you how to use the new Microsoft Planner in Microsoft Teams. This will provide you one place to capture and manage all of your work. Let's go ahead to start this by going and opening the new Planner. I'm already in the new Microsoft Teams here. I'm going to go over to the left and click Apps, and we're going to do a quick search here, and you're going to see Planner come up right here. As soon as I open it here, you'll notice it on the left-hand side. If I want it to stay here, just pin it. I'm going to right-click and pin so I can always quickly come back to this. So what is the new Planner? The new Microsoft Planner combines the best aspects of Microsoft To Do, Microsoft Planner, and Microsoft Project for the web in a single AI-powered app. It's designed to offer a straightforward, collaborative, and adaptable way to manage everything from personal tasks to large-scale projects. Let's do a quick tour of the new Microsoft Planner so I can show you how easy navigation is. Now, if I take a look over to the left, we have My Day, My Task, and My Plans. And you can see how quickly you can change the view to take a look to see what you have to do. Now, starting with My Day shows you all the items, the tasks that you have to complete that day. And as you go through them, you can check them off and you can see how they get completed as done. And up here it shows me the 3 out of 6. If I go and just scroll over on the side here, you can see all the different columns that will show me details about that task. So whether it be completed or in progress, the due dates, how important it is, and all of these you can sort. So if I was going to go and just click down on any of these, I can sort ascending, descending. If you want to see more details on these tasks, you could hover over and you'll get the open details. And if you need to make any changes to these, so if something is all of a sudden not important, you could go to medium. And as you exit out, you're going to have that change reflected here. So it makes a very easy way to navigate your day. You can add more tasks right from here. If I was going to jump over into To Do here, you'll notice that the same tasks are going to be in here, and it shows me which ones are completed. But instead of going to To Do or these other apps that I mentioned at the beginning, this allows you to do everything in one place. Now, let's take a look over at my task over here. So these are tasks, and they're going to be filtered up top by all right away, and you can see where different ones are coming from. So even in a flagged email from Outlook, it will show this up right here, and I have a few of these. It shows me that where these different ones are coming from, what different plans, and I can take these quick looks based on the plan. And again, all the sorting is there. As I scroll over, you can see all the different ones, whether or not there is an attachment to it. I can view the attachment from this spot. So again, it's especially working in Microsoft Teams, this allows you just to go to this one place to see any assigned tasks to you. And if I go through, if I wanted to see which ones have been assigned to me, I can just filter like this and it gets the list shortened, and I can look specifically for those ones. If I wanted to look at for those flagged emails, I can see them here. Or my private task, if I just want to see the ones that I've created for myself, I can quickly scan through the different list here. Now, let's move over to my plans here for this third view. You'll be able to see all the different plans that are coming from other apps as well. So if I was going to go and take a look back again at my to-do list, you can see that how I have video editing and Microsoft videos over here. And as I go back, this is all connected here. So all of them, all these different apps are connected, integrated, and I can come to this one place to view these. And I can hit the show more. Again, we have our different ways to quickly filter even through here with Microsoft Teams. Let's take a look at this plan as an example that I already created. I actually created this plan in Microsoft Planner over here. And just to show you how everything's integrated again, that plan went over through here. If I make a plan here, it will show up in Planner. So everything is just synced all together. Now, if I click on this plan, you'll see that inside these plans, I can quickly have my list like I had before when I was showing you my task, but these tasks are connected to that plan. I can quickly change change to the different views. So if you like a board view, and I can go and add my task to each of these. And then whether or not I have a bucket here, but here we have self-assessment, define the opportunity. As I scroll through, you see all the different things, depending on how you like to view your plans. We have a schedule here that we can quickly look at the calendar when the different dates of each of these plans, and I can check any of these off if I want to mark them as complete. And we also do have charts where I can quickly take a look at the status of different of the different tasks that are there, or which ones aren't started, are started. So you can get a good understanding of what's happening with your projects. So if I click on my plans again, let's go ahead and create a new plan. We have a few different quick ways we can do this. We have new plan here, create new plan, or new plan. They're all going to do the same thing. So if I go ahead and create a new plan, I could start with just a basic plan. So if you wanted to start from scratch here, I could just go ahead and give a name. Let's call this demo. I could go and pin this. So this over here is pinned. I'll show you that in a moment, how you can unpin as well. So if I say I wanted this pin, is there a group I want to add this to? So is there a Microsoft team or group that I've already created that I could just quickly select here? This is optional, I don't have to do this, but let's say I wanted to add it to the Pooch House Spa here. I could go ahead and create this. Oh, now it's creating a plan. Since I had this pinned here, it's going to show up here. If you didn't want it pinned, I could unpin it as well. So if I go back to my plans, I could go to recents. Here's the demo one that I just was showing you, that I just created. And then there's the other plans as well. So depending on how you want to view your different plans. So if I want to go back, I can click on this demo one, and I can go ahead and add my task from here. So if I wanted a new bucket name, I could give it a bucket name, and now I can add task under it. So it's very easy to develop it as you go along. So any of these tasks that you add, you can enter a task name, set a due date, and assign it to a person. So then they're gonna get notified if they're part of the team. Let's do a quick example under the board view that I'm up here. So if I go ahead and say email clients, I can set a due date. Friday, we'll say, we'll assign it. We'll pick a couple people to assign, and I can go ahead and add the task. Here it is right here. So notice I can have a quick look at the due date here and which people are assigned to here. I can click the ellipsis, I can label it from here. So if I wanted to add a label to it, if I also just click on it, it will open up all the different details, and I can go and change my labels at this point if I wanted to, or add more people to this as well. And as I go through this, you'll notice that you can have your notes, you can save as repeating, what's the priority going to be, add a checklist item, have an attachment, all these different things. And as I click off of it, notice that these updates are right here. And if I decided, you know, I want this in a different bucket list, so if I say bucket, maybe this is all about emails over here. If I go now, I can just simply drag this over into this to help me keep organized. If I look at the grid view now, I can see that we have this one task here that I could check off this way, or I can go to the schedule and see that it's on the schedule. Now, another way to create your plans would be to click new plan, is to use the templates. And I like using this way because it has a kind of give you a lot of ideas how you might set things up. I'm going to go click on see all templates here, and it gives you a view of what it looks like here. So you can go and find something that you like here, and you can just simply use it. So if I was just going to use this project management one, I could say use template. It has the name. I could change this. Do I want this pinned here? Is there a certain group that I would like to add it to? So now I could go ahead and hit create, and it's going to save me a few steps, and I can use the way that they have it set up with their different buckets through here. And like I said, it just saves you a lot of time thinking about what you might want, but this is all editable. Any of these things, right click, delete, move the task, copy the task. Same thing with any of these. You can right click, delete. So you can really just quickly change any of these. If I go over to my Teams, and let's say we go to this Pooch House one, so I'm just under the general channel, I can go ahead and add a tab here. And if I look at Planner, and I can now pick, now let's pick that demo one. I have Simple Plan or Demo. I'm going to pick the demo one. I applied it to this channel already or this team, and I can go ahead and hit Save. So now it gives me another tab up across in the channel that I'm under the general one. If I go across, I have it all set up here and I can still change the view. So this is nice within a team that you're all in that shared place and you can look at the assignments and check them off together and it gives that quick view for them. Let's head back to the planner over here on the side. So I'm just going to click planner. And if I look at my task, look at this. So I created that and it shows up over here because it was assigned to me. If I want to make sure it's added to my day, I'm just going to hit the ellipsis and hit click add to my day. I can check my day over here. Now I see it over here. If I check it here, it's going to be connected back to wherever I created it and it will show that I'm done it. So I hope you like this walkthrough of how to use the new Microsoft Planner in Microsoft Teams. I really like how it integrates everything together into one place that can save me a lot of time. Thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.